Making headlines tonight, discipline, good field placings, key for Warrington. Man City regained 3-point lead after Man United's record-equalling performance. And Grenada World Champs says Tokyo worth the risk. Good evening and welcome to the Major ZDK Sports Edition for Wednesday, February 3, 2021. I am your presenter, Terry Laraji, and now for the details. We begin tonight bowling up with cricket. West Indies left-arm spinner Jamal Warrington has credited discipline, accuracy and strong field settings as crucial factors that enabled him to grab a 3-wicket haul on day one of the first test against Bangladesh in Chattogram overnight. Playing his first international match in over a year, he claimed 3 for 58 off 24 probing overs to keep West Indies in the game.
Being disciplined and being accurate at the same time, and setting the right fields. I want to say I have a lot of assistance today. I got some balls to turn, but I wasn't turning consistently that you could say that I was assisting you all the time. So you just had to be disciplined and avoid ball in the right areas.
Jamal Warrington. After Bangladesh won the toss and decided to bat, West Indies bowlers did well on a very slow pitch that offered not much assistance, having Bangladesh in trouble at 134 for 4 and later 193 for 5. But solid batting from Litton Das and Shakib Al-Hassan helped them post 98 runs in the final session for the loss of only 1 wicket, the home side taking 40 runs off the last 10 overs of the day against the second new ball after Das was dropped by Nkuma Bonner, a sharp chance at forward short leg of the last delivery with the old ball from the hand of Rakim Cornwall. Score stumps day one, Bangladesh 242 for 5, Islam 59, Shakib 39 not out, Warrington 3 for 58. The West Indies will be looking for quick wickets on day two as Warrington believes they let Bangladesh off the hook in today's final session.
I think they played well, they kept the patience for a bit. I think as a bowling unit we let them off in the last session. So they didn't show good with ball because we was controlling the scoring very well. But saying that, well played to the batsmen as well and very well done to the guys.
However, Warrington noted it is a good batting surface.
The pitch is very good for batting. I mean, the ball's a bit harder. I saw Big Jim got some turn, but as the ball got older, you could see how good the wicket was and had to be disciplined in order to get wickets and build pressure.
Left-arm spinner Jamal Warrington. West Indies have gone into the match without fast bowler Antigua's own Alzari Joseph, preferring batting all-rounder Kyle Mayers, who was making his test debut, along with Nkuma Bonner and Shane Mosley. And Sri Lanka's tour of the West Indies could be rescheduled after head coach Miki Arthur and batsman Lahiru Thirumani tested positive for coronavirus. Arthur and opener Thirumani are following government health protocols after discovering they had contracted COVID-19 in the latest round of testing on Tuesday. Sri Lanka are due to head out to the Caribbean this month, but the tour may be put back. 3 ODIs of the tour are scheduled to take place here in Antigua at the Sir Vivian Richards Cricket Stadium, while the rest of the tour consists of 2 test matches and 3 T20 internationals. Meantime, West Indies Red Ball captain Jason Holder, who opted out of the Bangladesh tour, has hit back against criticism from legendary West Indies fast bowler Sir Andy Roberts. Roberts recently described all-rounder Holder as a damn good cricketer, but said he is lost as a captain and should look to the coaching staff for help during matches. Speaking on Voice of Barbados last night, Holder said he feels the legends are always negative.
I feel as though a lot of the time when you have the former legends comment on West Indies cricket, 99% of the time is negative. And then when it is an opportunity for them to give encouragement or to actually congratulate players, it is almost like they're trying to pick the teeth to find the words to say. It's like it's a hard thing to do.
According to Holder, current players don't want to see the former greats because they feel they are not approachable.
For me, it would warm my heart to sit and have a conversation with Andy Roberts. For well, Andy, you're entitled to say what you want to say, but pick up the phone. Mm-hmm. You're not getting contact. But I know, for instance, when they talk to players currently, they don't want to see half of the legends because they're so critical of them. And then there's a case where when we see them, it's not a case where a lot of them are approachable and you reach out to them.
Jason Holder. Holder is currently ranked 2nd in the world as an all-rounder in the latest ICC test rankings. However, in 37 test matches that he has captained the Windies, he has won only 11. Meanwhile, such greats like Sir Kirtley Ambrose, Windies teammate Ridley Jacobs, and classic batsman and current LICB president Enoch Lewis are just three of the champions that the small Antiguan village of Sweets has produced. And after holding a successful hardball cricket revival camp in August last year, the village is now taking things one step further. Commissioner of Sports Colin James, while speaking on the Sportsline show, told of how Sweets is about to launch another training program on the back of the success of the first.
The community-wide Sweets cricket program. So in other words, not only just the 5 to 15, even 11 and older, who wants to play hardball cricket and represent the community. That program, well, we're going to start that on the 9th of February. As I said, we're speaking to a high-profile coach. We have already had the discussion. We're meeting with him again today to iron out all the necessary details to have his services available. And pretty short, we would make the announcement.
According to James, the training is all geared around re-entry back into the parish league.
So what I can say now, I have already had some discussions with the parish league organizers. We're just waiting to submit some names or the names of the players. So if there's any interested cricketer, doesn't have to be from Sweets. Once they want to play in the parish league and you want to play with a team, that's always the foundation. And I always believe starting at the foundation, you build a base, you can always move forward, you can always improve, you can always graduate, but never forget the base. That is the most important thing. So that's why we started to build the base from the grassroots level.
Colin James. The training program balls off on February 9 from 3 p.m. and for further information, please contact Colin on 726-6647. And Windies all-rounder Robin Powell smashed an unbeaten half-century as Northern Warriors extended their winning run with a three-run victory over Windies white ball captain Kyron Pollard's Deccan Gladiators in the Abu Dhabi T10 League yesterday. Powell struck 51 not out off 23 balls, lead Warriors to 143 for 4 batting first. In reply, Pollard failed with 9 as Gladiators came up short at 140 for 6 of their allocated 10 overs. Today, Chris Gayle plundered 84 runs from just 22 balls as Team Abu Dhabi defeated Maratha Arabians by 9 wickets. The 41-year-old Gayle achieved a strike rate of 381.82, smashing 6 fours and 9 sixes in a brutal onslaught on the Arabians' bowling that powered his side, chasing 98 for victory to 100 for 1 of just 5.3 overs. Meanwhile, the Babis Cricket Board are in the process of signing an agreement with West Indies player Shimron Hetmyer to set up the Shimron Hetmyer Babis Cricket Development Fund. The three-year contract would involve $700,000 Guyanese for purchasing cricket balls to donate to clubs across Burbese and $200,000 for a University of Guyana scholarship for a cricketer living in the area. Additionally, from 2022, the fund would pay the cost of CSEC for two students from the Burbese High School. The Burbese Cricket Board said Hetmyer and his family have been very generous to the board and have already committed to sponsoring three tournaments at the cost of $500,000. Young Hetmyer is the pride and joy of Burbese after making his West Indies Test debut in 2017. And after 6 rounds of the Antigua and Barbuda Cricket Association ABCA Super 40 tournament, Darren Benter leads the batting aggregate with 353 runs from Ian Osabe with 254, Abia Christian on 243, Karima Gore on 226, Jermaine Otto on 220, and Coffee James on 203 runs. While the leading wicket takers are Essen Warner and Larry Joseph on 15 wickets, from Tiem Tong with 13, Coffee James on 12, and Winston Nelson on 10 wickets. Matches continue this Saturday when All Saints play Jennings at Jennings, Pickets play Bowlers at Pickets, Rising Sun come up against Combined Schools at Rising Sun, Liberta face Empire at King George, and Leaders Bethesda will play New Winthrops at New Winthrops. While on Sunday, Combined Schools face Empire at King George, Jennings face Pickets at Pickets, Bethesda come up against Rising Sun at Rising Sun, Bowlers play Liberta at Jennings, and All Saints will face New Winthrops at New Winthrops. All matches bowl off at 11 a.m, so do come on out and support some exciting local cricket. In other sporting developments tonight, slamming into dominoes, Anderson Carty Brothers and Sisters Dominoes Club of the Grays Green Community are hosting a dominoes competition which commenced on Saturday, January 30 and will continue on Saturday, February 6, starting at 4 p.m. to allow for the new curfew time. any inquiries, please call Swango Mark on 771-2445. Kicking into football in the English Premier League last night, Manchester United equaled the Premier League record by putting 9 goals past 9-man Southampton, the second time the Saints have lost 9-0 in as many seasons, as United joined Man City on top of the table. Sheffield United defeated West Brom 2-1, Wolves beat Arsenal 2-1, while Crystal Palace got over Newcastle also 2-1. However, today, thanks to goals from Jesus and Sterling, ensured Man City a 2-0 victory over Burnley to regain their 3-point advantage on top with a game in hand, while Leicester moved to third with a 2-0 win over Fulham. Meantime, England will host games against Austria and Romania in June in preparation for the rearranged Euro 2020. The fixtures were originally due to take place last summer, but were postponed, along with the tournament itself, amid the coronavirus pandemic. Austria will play England on Wednesday, June 2, with Romania set for Sunday, June 6. Shooting into basketball in the NBA last night, the Raptors wrapped up the Magic 123-108. The Nets clipped the Clippers 124-120 as Harden dropped in 23. The Pacers beat the Grizzlies 134-116 as Sabonis scored 32. The Trailblazers blazed the Wizards 132-121 as Lillard netted 32. The Jazz beat the Pistons 117-105 as Mitchell scored also 32. And the Celtics, they defeated the Warriors 111-107 despite Stephen Curry's 38. Serving into tennis, between 500 and 600 Australian Open players, officials and support staff will go into isolation after a worker at one of the event's quarantine hotels tested positive for coronavirus. Thursday's play at the 6 warm-up events at Melbourne Park is said to be affected by the move, says Victoria Premier Daniel Andrews. But Andrews said, at this stage there is no impact on the tournament proper, as players will be free to return to competing after a negative test. The Australian Open, which was pushed back by 3 weeks to enable players to quarantine, starts on Monday. It hasn't interrupted Serena Williams's preparations, though, as the American roared into the quarterfinals of the Yarra Valley Classic with a 6-1, 6-4 victory over Svetlana Pirankova on a star-studded day of action in Australia. The 23-time Grand Slam champion was in fine form at Melbourne Park, where the biggest names in women's tennis were competing across multiple tournaments, as she sealed a straight sets triumph to continue her preparations for a shot at an 8th Australian Open title. Running into athletics, Anderson Peters, the 2019 World Championships javelin gold medalist, believes it is well worth the risk travelling to Japan to compete at the Olympic Games this summer, despite the threat posed to his safety by the COVID-19 virus. The 23-year-old Peters, who is eager to add an Olympic title to his World, Pan American and NACAC titles, admitted to Sportsmax TV that he's concerned about his safety, especially against the backdrop of news of recent spikes in Japan that have organizers questioning whether the games that were postponed from last summer should go ahead this year. However, the Grenadian national record holder believes there is no reward without great risk. The 2020 Olympics, billed as the celebration of humankind's victory over coronavirus, could fall foul of the pandemic for a second time. But according to Tokyo 2020 president Yoshiro Mori, the games will go ahead this summer, however the coronavirus evolves. And finally tonight, on this day in history, in 1974, when Bernard Julian played the last ball of the second day of the first test between England and the West Indies gently down the pitch, the non-striker, Alvin Kalicharan, 142 not out, strode off for a well-earned rest. But Tony Gregg threw down the stumps and appealed, and the umpire in question, Douglas Sanghu, had little choice but to give Kalicharan a run out. It caused a huge furor, and eventually, after lengthy off-field discussions, Gregg retracted his appeal. And that story has brought us to the end of our sporting developments for tonight. Now to recap our top story. West Indies left-arm spinner Jamal Warrican has credited discipline, accuracy and strong field settings as crucial factors that enabled him to grab a 3-wicket haul in day one of the first test against Bangladesh in Chattagram overnight. The home side closed the day on 242/5. I've been your presenter, Terry Laraji. Thank you for listening. To watch ZDK Sports Package, go to the YouTube channel, Terry Laraji, The Straight Bat, and subscribe. Stay tuned now for your Voice of America update. Do enjoy the rest of your evening.
Rally round the West Indies, one forever.